ओके, आई विल स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग एंड देन प्रेजेंटेशन. तो वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस सेशन. ओके, तो आई टोल्ड यू दैट वी हैव फिनिश्ड ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द फंडामेंटल पार्ट्स. नाउ विल सी द सीवर डिजाइन, हाइड्रोलिक डिजाइन ऑफ द सीवर. इन अ हाइड्रोलिक डिजाइन ऑफ सीवर I will start presentation. Hydraulic design of sewer, that how the sewage is going to be flow, what kind of maintenance we need to do while flowing the water sewage in a sewer line, that part we are going to see. Okay, so the very important I would like to tell you, we are going to study maximum and minimum velocities in sewer. We should learn while you are starting the design for the sewerage system. At that time, first of all, you should think about the maximum and minimum velocity in sewer, then hydraulic characteristics of circular sewer when it is running full and when it is running partially full at both the condition. Okay, so this part we are going to study in today's lecture. Now I will stop sharing and let me check whether I have started the recording. You may be observing that I have started. Yes, it is started. Okay, so this part we are going to study today, maximum. So first of all, we will study about the maximum and minimum velocities in sewer line. So in the maximum and minimum velocity, what is meant by maximum velocity and what is meant by minimum velocity and why should we maintain these two, that we will discuss. So while starting, during this chapter explanation itself, I told you what is the maximum velocity and what is the minimum velocity and why should go for. So first of all, we will discuss about the minimum velocity. The sewage contains particles in suspension, the heavier of which may settle down at the bottom of sewers as and when the flow velocity reduces, resulting in the clogging of sewers. Okay, I request you, whatever the slides you are observing, whenever I will ask you, you should keep on writing. Is it? So what is the impact of minimum velocity of flow? That when minimum velocity of flow is there, and if it is the plain water, there is no issue. But if it is the sewage which contains the suspended particles, which are having tendency to settle down at the low velocity, in that case, you should worry about the minimum velocity of flow to avoid the clogging of sewer line. So slowly it will start depositing, and a huge amount of sludge will keep on depositing at the bottom. And after some time, it will block the sewer line, which is not affordable to us. Is it? So that's why we should take care about the minimum velocity of flow. Okay, to avoid silting of sewer, it is necessary that the sewer pipes be laid at such a gradient as to generate the self-cleansing velocity at different possible discharges. A self-cleansing velocity, what is meant by self-cleansing velocity? The velocity at which the particles, suspended particles in sewage, will not be allowed to settle down at the bottom is nothing but the self-cleansing velocity. So minimum velocity of the sewer line should be equal to or greater than the self-cleansing velocity. Should not be less than the self-cleansing velocity of that particular sewer line. Okay, remember that line. Once again, I will repeat. Minimum velocity of flow of a sewer line should be equal to or greater than the self-cleansing velocity. It should not be less than that, to avoid the clogging of the sewer line, is it? And at the same time, to get proper self-cleansing velocity in a particular sewer line, we should maintain gradient in a pipe in a such a way that it will help to have the self-cleansing velocity. Gradient in the sense, a slope. A little slope is required to get the proper self-cleansing velocity in a sewer line. Okay, so I hope you have copied this slide. silting of sewer. What is mean by silting of sewer? In the sense, I told you, the question is raised in the chat box. What is mean by silting of sewer? Silting of sewer. Sewer line, you understood. The sewer is nothing but the pipe, closed conduit through which sewage we are passing. Now, what is the characteristic of sewage? Sewage is having almost more than 50% or almost 50-60% solid particles. That is known as the suspended particles. Some of them may get settled down by the gravity, or some of may float on the surface. That is known as the suspended particles. In a sewage, there is a suspended particle. Sewage in the sense, what is the sewage? Domestic waste, okay, which includes the solid particles. If solid particles are there, they are having tendency to settle them at the low velocity. Is it? That is nothing but the silting of particles at the sewer. Are you getting? Silting manje the sediment hone, particle khali basne. Is it? So what sentence, where is the maintain? The sewage contains particles in suspension, the heavier of which settles down at the bottom of the sewer, and when the flow velocity reduces, resulting in the clogging of sewers. To avoid silting of sewers, yeah, it is written here. To avoid silting of sewer, in the sense, to avoid the sedimentation of particles in a sewer line. In short, it is written, to avoid silting of sewers. I hope I have answered correctly. Have you copied now? Shall we move to the next point? Okay. One more question is raised. Okay, thank you. We'll go to the next point. At minimum velocity, the flow velocity in the river sewers should be such that the suspended materials in sewage do not get silted up. That is, velocity should be such as to cause automatic self-cleansing effect. Such a way we should design the sewer line, which should get the automatic development of self-cleansing velocity. We should not take efforts. What efforts we need to take if the minimum velocity of flow is not being maintained in the sewer line? What efforts we need to take? We are supposed to flush the water randomly to remove the obstacles or to remove the silted particles in the sewer line. Does it possible? Again, it becomes a manual arrangement. So to avoid the manual arrangement, we should keep faith on automatic arrangement. And for that purpose, only we need to take care of two things, that minimum velocity of flow and another one is gradient. If both the cases we take care, there will not be a problem in the sedimentation. There will not be the problem of sedimentation of particle or silting of the material. Okay. Okay. Sorry to disturb you. The generation of such a minimum self-cleansing velocity in the sewer at least once a day is important, because if certain deposition takes place and is not removed, it will obstruct free flow, causing further deposition and finally leading to the complete blocking of sewer. Are you getting? What is expected here? Not necessary to entire day the minimum velocity of flow should be maintained. At least once in a day, it should maintain the minimum velocity of flow, which will not allow to settle down the particles at the bottom, and in turn, it will not be allowed to have the blockage of the sewer line. Ready? Is there anybody who is asking question? If not, please copy this slide. score. Shall we move to the next point? Roll number 26. Do you have any question? Abhijit Chavan. Who is Abhijit Chavan who has not connected with the audio system? Only started link but not connected with the audio system, Abhijit Chavan. Okay, I will move to the next point. Okay, the sewage contains particles in suspension. Is it that we have discussed already actually? I think it is repeated. The heavier of which may settle down at the bottom of the sewer, and when the flow velocity reduces, resulting in the clogging of sewer. To avoid silting of sewers, it is necessary that the sewer pipes be laid at such a gradient as to generate the self-cleansing velocity. Roll number two. Okay, now this is the formula to calculate the velocity of flow. Minimum velocity of flow. So this is design formula that V is equal to under root of 8k upon F into rho s minus rho upon rho into g into ds, where V is nothing but the minimum velocity of flow in a meter per second, k is nothing but the size of particles or solids in sewage, and then F is nothing but the Darcy coefficient of friction, and it is normally can be taken as 0.03. Rho s, usually we use that es, it is not es, you may be able seeing that it is es, but it is rho s. Rho is the density. Okay, rho s minus rho. Rho s is nothing but the specific gravity of solid particles present in a sewage, and it is usually varies between the 1.2 to 2.65, and rho is nothing but the specific gravity of sewage or the liquid, and which is generally we take it as 1. Then g into ds. What is g? Is nothing but the acceleration due to gravity, and ds is the diameter of solid particles. So I failed to write it in a proper manner, but I request you to write this formula in this manner, what way I announce it. V is equal to under root 8k upon F into rho s minus rho upon rho into g into ds. Copy this formula and write down about this. Then we'll move to the next point. सकाळी कुठला मॅथ्स होता काय तो कसं बाय ओके विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट मॅक्झिमम वेलॉसिटी ऑफ फ्लो नाव वाय टू मेंटेन द मॅक्झिमम वेलॉसिटी ऑफ फ्लो द स्मूथ इंटिरियर सर्फेस ऑफ अ सीवर फाईन पाईप gets soaked due to continuous abrasion caused by the suspended solids present in sewage. Now we have accepted that in a sewage there are the suspended particles. Maybe that particles are abrasive particles, sediment type of particles or floating particles. But if we are not worrying about the maximum velocity of flow and it is being maintained for maximum time of a day, at that time it will start soaring, that particles will strike upon the inner wall of the diameter of the pipe, inner wall of the sewer pipe, and that smooth surface will get affected and there will be the abrasion, is it? So at the last that pipe will go for the weakening, its strength, and then the leakages will be followed at the same time. So that's why we have to worry about the maximum velocity of flow. So the smooth interior surface of sewer pipe gets soaked due to continuous abrasion caused by the suspended solids present in sewage. It is therefore necessary to limit the maximum velocity in the sewer pipe. This limiting or non-soaring velocity will mainly depend upon the material of the sewer. If it is the metal, so it may not affect that much the way it is affecting on the cement pipe. That means the non-soaring velocity will mainly depend upon the pipe material, is it? The maximum velocity will depend upon the whether it is soaring or not. It will depend upon the type of material used for the construction of sewer line. Okay, so I hope this part also you have written. I will go to the next point. Shall I? Let's move to the next. Okay, now we will see the hydraulic characteristics of circular sewer when it is running full and when it is running partially full. Okay, so I have drawn here figure of circular sewer, so you also can draw this figure, hydraulic characteristic of circular sewer when it is running full or partially full. So what is the running full condition and what is the running partially full condition? So you just see this figure and give the notations whatever I have given in the next figure, in my figure. So draw this figure. Okay, you can draw this figure. D is the diameter of circular sewer. Capital D is the diameter of circular sewer. And section is triangle is made with the capital A O B A, that is the triangle, is it? So I will take help of and note it. Okay, you can see here this is the A O and A O B A. Okay, this is the triangle. This is the complete inner diameter of circular sewer, and here you can see this is the depth of sewage or the depth of flow where the sewage is flowing when it is a partially full condition. Full condition in the sense whatever the diameter is given, it is running full. Partially full in the sense it may run up to. It may run up to here, it may run up to this, is it? So that is known as the partially full condition. So you can imagine. Okay, so for your understanding, I have made this, now I will remove this. So you can draw this figure. Jovan Kapoor. Okay, once you finish the diagram, let me know. Finished. Okay, hope you have finished this circular sewer. We are going to study how it is going to flow the water. Okay, this is the small D is shown to you, where the depth of water when it is running partially full. Okay, now there are two conditions I told you. One, first condition is when it is running full, and another condition is running partially full. Okay, so the first condition, circular section running full, in that condition you can imagine D is the diameter, internal diameter of the circular sewer. Okay, and at that time what will be the area, that is cross sectional area? Definitely it will be A is equal to pi by 4 d square, and at that condition what will be the wetted perimeter? P is equal to pi d, is it? And from that we can calculate the hydraulic mean depth, or we can say it is HMD, and that notation is R, capital R is equal to capital A upon capital P is equal to d by 4, because capital A is pi by 4 d square and upon pi d. So final answer, you will get the d by 4 for the hydraulic mean depth of R, is it? So you, once again you can see this is the diameter. Okay, this is the circular sewer when it is running full. That entire area is coming into picture. So that's why capital A, we had given capital notations for the when the condition is running full. Okay, now we are concentrating towards the when the hydraulic sewer is running full. At that condition, this capital D will be the diameter of inner diameter of the sewer line. Capital A will be the cross-sectional area. And how to calculate cross-sectional area? Pi by 4 into D square, is it? Now what is the perimeter, what wetted perimeter we can say, which will be, what will be the wetted perimeter? Definitely entire area will be the entire perimeter will be the wetted perimeter. So we will give the notation capital P. In that condition, capital P is equal to what will be the perimeter? That is pi into capital D. D is the diameter. Then from that we can calculate R is equal to hydraulic mean depth, that is capital A upon capital P is equal to hydraulic mean depth. Capital A is pi by 4 d square upon pi d is equal to d by 4. The final answer for the R is equal to will be the d by 4. Getting? So this will be the situation when it is running full. Okay, now we'll see the second condition. Let me erase this. What let it be? Okay, no, it has to be erased. Okay, time being, you note down please. This I will erase it. So a is the pi by 4d square, pi is p is equal to pi d, r is equal to a upon p is equal to d by 4. So may I go to the next point? Next point is the when it is running partially full. So at this condition, now partially full in the sense somewhere it is running. In the earlier, at the start also I explained to you how it will run. It will run somewhere where there is a here we have taken it is running this much. And because of that, this depth we are taking into consideration small d. Is it? Small d is the with the depth of partial flow. Okay, if you found writing, please. Small d with the depth of partial flow. Now p. P is the wetted perimeter. When it is running partially full, what perimeter is coming into picture? Only this perimeter is coming into picture. So small p is the wetted perimeter. Now area, cross-sectional area. So what cross-sectional area is coming into picture? Only this part will be the coming into picture as a cross-sectional area of the when the sewer is running at the partially full condition. Then R is the hydraulic mean depth of that portion. Okay. Now small v is the velocity of flow, and if it is running full at that condition, so capital V will be the velocity of flow. So these notations we have given. Okay, now here it is difficult to find out the area of that portion or all these things. So that's why we have converted that figure further into this way. Okay, it is connected that way. So this way it has converted into a section. It has become a section. Now once it becomes a section, easy to determine the area of that particular region. So we are going to see that part in the next figure. Okay, next part. So I hope you have copied this one. Then I can move to the next point. So many times I have copied this figure to give you a reference, because in a physical class, I can draw the figure at one corner of the board and then I can keep on explaining the derivation. But it is difficult here. So I'm trying to do the way we are doing in the class. So here I told you know that our college is not running now. And that's why I have to conduct classes through this forum instead of the board, the way I was conducting earlier. Now you can see here what we have to find out. First of all, we should be able to find out that theta. We should be able to find out the depth. That this is the depth. I told you this is the depth at which the sewage is running in that depth. Okay, now how to calculate that depth? So I told you this is the area what we are going to consider here. Now, if this area is going to be considered here, creates a mini problem, yeah. Why it is not taking? by the time you copy this part, I will. I'm taking help of Arnold. Okay. Every time I should go back. Okay, so this is the depth what we are going to consider for the when the sewer is running full. Now that we have to determine how we can go for determining that cos theta by 2. So this is the angle in a section, the angle has been formed and that angle is nothing but the theta. Okay, so these are the two triangles has been formed and both the triangles are the 90 degree triangles. So it is easy to find out the area, okay, of that section, or everything is possible to go for. So I have started to find out cos theta by 2. Here is the theta, complete is the theta. It is divided into two parts. So I can say it is a cos theta by 2 is equal to OC. What is the OC? This is the O and this is the C point. OC upon D by 2 is the diagonal. Okay. So what is that OC? OC is nothing but complete D by 2. This is the D by 2 minus that small d. Is it? So OC is equal to D by 2 minus